Thousands of years ago, our earliest ancestors might have picked up a pointed rock and spun it between their hands to bore a hole in something they wanted to modify. Today, you can buy drill bits in all shapes and sizes. Drill bits are often associated with carpentry, but from electronics to surgery tooling, there are all kinds of fields that require ultra-thin, high-performance drill bits. The production process begins with lengths of 100% carbide called blanks. A diamond grinding wheel lubricated with a specialized cutting liquid is applied to a chamfered edge on one tip of the blank. This step removes the rough edges left when the blanks were cut down to size. A vibrating device organizes the blanks inside a rotating bowl. The vibrating action shifts the blanks into single file so they can proceed one by one to the next step. This machine is called a centerless grinder. The blanks move between two rotating drums, which grinds them down to a specified length. The blanks pour out of the machine, immersed in the lubricating fluid. An operator selects one and places it in a quality control gauge to check that it meets the manufacturer's required tolerances. The blanks now enter a CNC Rolo Matic. An operator sets up the tool and programs its work process. A robotic auto feeder picks up the blanks one by one from a specialized pallet. The robotic arm places each blank carefully and precisely in a waiting chuck or collar, and then moves them back into position. The tool moves forward, holding the blank perfectly still as a pair of wheels close in. Liquid coolant pours over the blank as the wheels precision pinch grind the tip of the blank, grinding it down to about 1/10 of a millimeter, the width of a human hair. It's a delicate process. The Rolo-Matic produces 48 pieces per hour. Next, a technician places small sheets of plastic foil in a jig. The foil is shim stock, color-coded according to its thickness. The jig raises the metal support to a specified height. When the blank advances over the support, a mark left in the blue ink determines whether the metal blank is centered. Once complete, technician uses a magnifying tool to fine-tune the placement of the blank and ensure that it's perfectly centered. This process can take 4 to 5 hours. The blank is finally ready for the crucial fluting process that will transform it from a cylindrical length of carbide with a narrow tip into a micro drill bit. After hours of preparation, this operation takes just a few seconds. An industrial grinding diamond wheel has sliced a microscopic groove at a precise angle. The technician inserts the bit, sharp end first, into a precision machining device. A steel bushing with the brass insert holds the tip of the bit in place as a cutting wheel slices an angled point. It's impossible to see the difference between a bit before and after fluting. Using a magnifying device, the technician conducts a quality control check of the bit. As the screen reveals the finely cut flute, the technician ensures the tool's parameters meet manufacturing standards. One such parameter has to do with the shape of the flute, which has a forward taper. This means the flute groove becomes shallower from tip to base at a very precise angle. This feature simultaneously strengthens the tool while increasing the chip flow along the groove. Although carbide is incredibly strong, when it's milled to the thickness of a human hair, it becomes fragile. Needless to say, careful packaging is extremely important.